Hi, my name is Ethan Driller.
I'm Sam Brenner.
Our project is Cosmic Capture, using household materials to detect cosmic rays. We're in ninth grade, and we're doing physics and astronomy. What inspired us to do this is that we were really interested in physics and astronomy and particle physics, and we really wanted to do programming as well. Cosmic rays are high-speed particles that impact Earth, and their origin is from like supernovas and other celestial bodies, and lower energy particles can come from the sun.
Cosmic rays typically travel at 99% the speed of light, and they're used by physicists to collect data. So when we collect these, we're hoping to be able to use this to help physicists. So like, if they're doing data on something, a cosmic ray could potentially be an outlier. And if they know that it's an outlier and that it's a cosmic ray, they will have much more accurate data.
So we're trying to use a solid-state device, like a camera, which captures light and converts it into data. And the image quality is determined by the size of an image sensor, the number of light-sensitive photosites, and the size of the pixels.
Python, which is the programming language that we used, is a high-level programming language, and that means that when we write it, it's easier for us to understand, and then the computer breaks it down into simpler and simpler machine code until it can understand it itself and run that program. It's also very effective with the use of modules, which are community-generated lines of code that can also do other things. So like, if we wanted to say, I don't know, if we wanted to have our program say detect the amount of light in this pixel and then this pixel and do that over and over again, we could just find something online that tells us what it is, and then we can just copy paste that into our program.
Our engineering goal is to program a computer to detect cosmic rays inexpensively using off-the-shelf components like our surface webcam or duct tape that we've been using, electrical tape. And our question was, does the detection of cosmic rays change at different elevations and places? And our hypothesis is, if cosmic rays are detected at different locations and elevations, then the location with the lowest elevation will detect the most cosmic rays, because when cosmic rays hit the atoms in our atmosphere, it creates a secondary cascade of particles, which are called muons, and we can pick those up and there'll be more of them.
So when we covered our computer with electrical tape, we're hoping that some of the cosmic rays could potentially impact this, and when they hit it, it'll create enough light where the computer camera, where the webcam will pick it up, and we can tell our program to count that as a cosmic ray.
Our program was written in Python, and it captures images rapidly in a stream, and it analyzes each pixel in the image to determine the color. And how we determine the color is predetermined, background color.
Background color is determined by taking the average of 100 black images that we also used with the same webcam, and averaging out what the red, green, and blue values were, and we can put that in as our background color so our computer will know what is a cosmic ray and what isn't.
So our cosmic ray intensity, which is meaning like the different locations that we're trying to go for, we collected data at 8 different locations and elevations, and each place that we collected data was taken with 100 frames. And the amount of time to analyze each set of data that we used varied. And it was instead of a set time, it was a fixed number of images.
The table 1 shows the average number of cosmic ray detections according to location and elevation. Figure 1 shows the average number of cosmic ray hits according to location and elevation. Figure 2 shows the average number of cosmic ray detections versus elevation. And figure 3 shows the elevation versus location from east to west. So it's kind of a side view of where we collected data, with the low point here being Lake Superior, and all the way over here is around Big Lake area.
Our conclusion was was that our engineering goal was partially achieved since it did not accurately detect that many cosmic rays, and that there are many different outliers that we need to take into account for. So our hypothesis was neither supported nor refuted because of that fact, and that we need to tweak our program to make sure that it actually detects it accurately.
So a physicist named Dr. Alec Habig said that if we take 100 square centimeters at 30 frames per second, we should be detecting 2 to 4 cosmic rays. So that means that if we take about 2,000 images, we should expect the same results. And since our average was somewhere around 1,200, we know that we need to increase the RGB values to accurately detect cosmic rays.
Because of this, our program that needed a lot of tweaking, a new program is in development. And it analyzes frames in a much quicker fashion. As you can see here, it's got the average threshold of detections of 2 to 4 per 2,000 frames. So we're tuning it to detect an expected number of cosmic rays instead of multiple too many outliers.
So we would like to thank Dr. Cynthia Welsh for putting us on the path of Science Fair and encouraging us to go above and beyond. And we'd like to thank William Bauer for teaching us the Python programming language and helping us understand particle physics a little bit better, and especially our parents for driving us to the data collection points and helping us complete this project at home.
Any questions?